It's another first for Curtin. It's the first automated driverless bus. I'm just gonna hop in and see what people have to say about it.
It's really clean and it's really nice. It's tidy.
Oh, I absolutely love it. Just the way it drives on its own.
How do you feel riding it?
It's comfortable. Yeah, it's comfortable. You feel safe, but without the driver, you know?
It goes with the regulations in uni. That's like the 20K zones and everything. So it just follows all of that. So it's pretty safe.
Kip has quite a few sensors. If you see over here, we have multiple LiDARs. Basically how Kip works is that he sends signals all across its body, so basically 360 degree view.
Yeah.
And based on that, it knows where it's going.
I think it'll definitely help when you're exhausted, just to hop on the bus and just kind of like clear your mind for a little bit while you get to your next destination.
So how did you get involved with this?
So I just applied through Curtin UniHub because I'm studying accounting and finance. Yeah. It's not really related to the technical stuff. Through Earn While You Learn, I got training, and after passing the test, I was chosen as a technician.
I thought it was a driverless bus. Why are you controlling it?
Interesting you ask. It's really a driverless bus. As you see, I'm not touching it, and that bus is moving itself. But I'm just here maintaining it. I'm the technician, so just in case something does happen. So it's pretty simple. On the monitor right now, as we see where we are, it gives us the time and how long it'll take us to reach the destination. As it goes down, it should stop at the speed bumps, it slows down, it stops the pedestrians.
On Fridays, the bus is used for research purposes, so not just for technical, but also there can be people from psychology department coming in through and taking a look at how people actually behave towards the bus, how safe they feel riding on this.
I think it's really exciting. I mean, this is sort of indicative of where the uni is heading. We're getting to see some sort of future ideas actually happening here at the campus.
It is, in a sense, the future where we're going towards sustainability. Yeah. There's no more petroleum, it's all electric. It is where we're going to be heading in my degree, well, at least in the next 10, 20 years.
Any student can access the bus. Our service starts from building 3 or 4 all the way down to the medical building, Monday to Thursday.
So as a petroleum engineer, are you worried this bus is going to put you out of business?
Well, if that's going to happen, I might find something else.